Welcome to the Mobile Money Nation. My name is AJ. Thanks for taking this time out of your day to watch this video. If you're not a current member of the Mobile Money Nation, hit the subscribe button down below. Make sure you hit the like button because you're really gonna like this video. And also hit the notification bell so you'll be notified the next time I create a video. Today I'm gonna talk about the Pay app, which is an application you can use to receive cash back whenever you shop in-store, online, or at specific retailers and restaurants. If you haven't seen my top 7 cashback apps, this is one of the apps that makes my top 7. And although it is one of the newer apps, it is actually one of the most beneficial apps for me as far as receiving cashback automatically. Now, over the time that I've used the app, which has been just over a couple of months, I've noticed that there have been a lot of different and new stores and restaurants that are added to the application. So it's great to see that the few options that I had available when I first actually signed up for the service, that it's increased just over about 2 or 3 months of me using the service. So the great thing that I've noticed over this time is that, you know, when I first looked at the app and there weren't that many stores, you know, I didn't really worry about it. I knew that I'm using multiple applications. And so it was a great surprise when I would get a notification from the Pay app that I just received cash back from a store that I wasn't expecting. So that's the great thing about using a cashback app where you receive automatic cashback and you don't have to think about what store you're going to and activate any specific offer. So in order for you to receive cashback automatically, the Pay app does use your location. That way, combined with you adding your credit card or your debit card and running that debit card as credit, once you have it connected to the Pay app and you have your location turned on, it will be able to recognize when you make that transaction and which specific store that you are close to determine that you actually used it at one of their merchant partners. And I say merchant partners, which is what they call it, because not all stores will give you cash back. So there may be, let's say if you go to Wendy's or if you go to Chick-fil-A, maybe all of those stores don't actually give you cash back, which is why they need your location in order to determine which one of those stores is actually giving you the cash back. So most of the time I don't even check out the app anymore. I'll just go and eat where I would normally eat. That way I'm not picking based on where I could get cash back at. But if I am making a decision between two different restaurants or maybe two different stores, then I may check all of my cashback apps to see which one I will actually receive cashback at. And then that could sway me to use one store versus using another. So another great way to earn cashback within the Pay app is via rideshare apps. So if you use Uber, you get a 3% cashback every time you use the Uber app. And if you use Lyft, you get a 1% cashback. Now, if you combine this with the other cashback apps that I've mentioned and the stockback apps, you can actually stack rewards in addition to the cashback credit card that you may already be using or the travel rewards card that you are already using. So potentially through Uber or Lyft or any of the retail stores that are available within the Pay app, you can combine that with the cashback from your credit card as well as the other cashback apps that are out there. So at any given time, you could have 2 or 3 different apps plus your credit card also giving you cash back for one purchase. Now, Pay also has what they call their online offers. And these are specific stores that if you were to shop online, you don't have to go through their app to activate the offer. You will automatically receive credit for those specific stores. Now, those online offers, there aren't actually that many stores that are available where you can receive the automatic cash back when you shop online. So you may want to check those out to see if any of those are beneficial to you. But for me personally, just restaurants in my local area and some retail stores when I shop in store, those have been the most lucrative for me when using the application. And there's also a way that you can boost your points. They have a feature called the Cashback Boost, where for a whole 48-hour period, you can actually receive 1% cashback on all of your purchases. And it doesn't have to be one of their approved merchants or one of their online stores or in-store restaurants or things like that. It would be any transaction that you make during that 48-hour period. And so this is another great way that you can earn cashback. So for instance, if you had the Citi Double Cash credit card, which automatically gives you 2% cashback, you can now automatically get 3% at least over a 48-hour period as long as you have that same card connected in the Pay app wherever you go and make a purchase. Now, in order to get that cashback boost, you have to gain at least 20 points through their point system. And with their point system, all you have to do is you get 1 point for linking a new card. You get 2 points for inviting a friend to use the Pay app. You get 1 point for cashing out via gift card. You can get 1 point for shopping at the same merchant 5 times. That gives you a loyalty bonus point. And you can get 2 points for shopping at 2 different preferred merchants available via the Pay app. Now, within that 48-hour period, you can only receive a maximum of $500 cash back, which isn't really a big deal for most people, because in order to earn $500 cash back, when you're only getting cash back for 1%, you'd actually have to spend $50,000 within that 48-hour period in order to reach the maximum amount. And for most people, you're not spending $50,000 in a 48-hour period. But if you know you're gonna be doing a lot of shopping within the next 48 hours, it's a great time to activate the boost if you already have the 20 points needed in order to activate the cashback boost. So if you happen to be going on vacation, or maybe you have to buy a gift for someone's birthday or a wedding or something like that, that would be a great time to activate that boost and make your normal shopping, maybe your groceries, and do all of those purchases within that 48-hour period. And of course, with the Pay app, just like many other apps, you do receive a bonus when you sign up. So if you want to sign up, make sure you use my link below to receive credit for the bonus. You will actually receive $2.50 after you make your first purchase at a Pay merchant where you receive cashback. And I'll have that code and the link in the description as well as in the comments below. So make sure you use that link so you can receive cashback once you first use your credit card via the Pay app. And with the Pay app, in order to cash out, you have to have a minimum $25 available in your cash back in order to cash out. And you have the option to cash out via gift cards, Bitcoin, or via PayPal, which is my favorite option. Now, once you receive that cash back, if you really want to do something smart with it, what you can actually do is use that cash back to pay down any debts that you have. So if you have any student loans, you have a mortgage, or you have any credit card debt, you can use that money to pay down those debts, or you can also use that free money that you receive by shopping at the places that you would have shopped anyway to now invest that cash back into the stock market. Webull is one such platform that you can use. Webull is a free investing app that doesn't charge fees when you trade stocks. And once you sign up and deposit at least $100 into your account, you receive 2 free shares of stock value between $12 and $1,400. And like I said, there's no fee to trade with Webull, so you can use your cash back and combine that with the other cash back from all of the other apps that you're using, combine that with the cash back from the credit cards that you're using, and now you have free money that you can use to pay down your debts faster or to invest in the stock market. And I'll have a link to Webull in the description so you can check that out as well. Also, if you check out my website, I have referral links to all of the investment apps that I've reviewed on my YouTube page. So you can check that out if you want to check out maybe a company like M1 Finance where you can buy fractional shares with just a couple of dollars. Now, the Pay app is in my top 7 cashback apps. Now, if you haven't seen my top 7 cashback app video, make sure you check that out as well to see where the Pay app lands in that top 7. I use the Pay app as long as the other apps in that top 7 cashback in order to stack my rewards on top of my credit cards where you can receive cashback more than one time. So let us know what you think in the comments below, whether this is an app that you're going to now use that you haven't used in the past, or if you've already been using the Pay app, talk about your experience in the comments below. Thanks for watching this video. If you're not a part of the Mobile Money Nation, you know exactly what to do. Hit the subscribe button down below. Hit the like button because you really like this video. And also hit the notification bell so you'll be notified the next time I make a video. Again, thanks for watching. Have a great day.